Hi-Fi Rush came out of nowhere, literally, as in it was announced and released on the same day, January 25th, 2023. That's right, it came out a week ago as of yesterday. It's something that's been done before to a varying degree of success, but I think this is the first time I've seen large swaths of people saying that a game released this way is a contender for Game of the Year. Looking at the games that are coming out this year, it makes me wonder, are these people onto something? Is Hi-Fi Rush from developer Tango Gameworks and publisher Bethesda Softworks really something that has the makings of a true Game of the Year contender? The reputation of Tango Gameworks speaks for itself, with such awesome games like the Evil Within series and last year's Ghostwire Tokyo under their belt. But none of these have ever reached a level I would consider a Game of the Year contender. So what has their latest outing being talked about on every corner of the internet with levels of praise that are off the charts? You're watching Jerwinko Gaming, and I'm your host, Jonathan Irwin Jerwinko here, and today I'm bringing you my thoughts on Hi-Fi Rush.
Well, I'm in. I hope no one noticed.
Hi-Fi Rush is an action-adventure rhythm game that puts players in the role of an aspiring rock star named Chai. Cocky, arrogant, and high on life, Chai fancies himself on top of the world at all times, and thinks that his path to greatness lies in a prosthesis as part of Project Armstrong from Vandalay Technologies. Though appearing to be a philanthropic organization from the outside looking in, the truth comes out quickly for Chai as Happenstance deems him a defect to be destroyed. Assembling a ragtag team of allies, Chai and company form a resistance against Vandalay, and across 12 tracks, what the game calls levels, they take the fight to the corporation. Everything in the game from footsteps to combat are set to the beat of the music, most of which is created in-house by Tango Gameworks, but also includes some tracks from musical acts such as Nine Inch Nails and The Prodigy. Your attacks, dodges, and parries all need to be on beat with the music to get a full appreciation of the intricacies of the combat system in this game. Your enemies are held to the same rule sets as you, where they also have to move on tempo to the songs, and the result is a catchy game formula that shines at its best in the heat of the moment. Level and character designs are brightly colored and reminiscent of early 2000s games when cel shading was at its peak, and to be entirely honest, most of the time it works in Hi-Fi Rush. I love that shit. I love how this game feels like you're playing a chaotic and wacky anime that does not take itself too seriously. But it's not all sunshine and rainbows for Hi-Fi Rush, as there are some serious flaws I do think people are overlooking in this game because of their excitement, and almost all of them manifest during the game's seventh level. Track number 7, The Climb, has the worst pacing of the entire game. True to its namesake, most of the chapter is spent climbing a massive tower while sprinkling some fights in the middle. After such a massive climb, I was expecting an epic boss battle. Instead, you walk in a circle, talking down the enemy for what felt like forever, with only a few sections of attacks in the middle. The level design here is incredibly weak, as it's just a giant tower with some lasers. There is almost no story progression with the exception of the very end of the chapter, and the fights themselves don't feel like they were placed to break up the monotony, but rather amplify it. Combine that with forespoken levels of cringe in the dialogue at the end, and I was not having a great time. Track number 7 almost killed the game for me, and its existence also made existing cracks show severely. For a rhythm game with a protagonist that is wanting to be a rock star, none of the music exactly falls into something that could be considered rock. The music isn't bad, whether it's the in-house music made with the game in mind, or the real-world tracks sprinkled into the game. Nine Inch Nails, 1 Million, and The Perfect Drug fit their respective boss fights. The Prodigy's Invaders Must Die absolutely stole the scene when it was used. But none of the music really seemed to fit into Chai's rocker lifestyle, and that was pretty jarring to me. Had it not been for track number 7 boring me to tears, I probably wouldn't have nitpicked as hard, but it was a perfect storm of bullshit. Thankfully, the chapters after number 7 recovered in spectacular form, and I went back to having myself a good old time of beating up robots. By the time the credits rolled, I found myself in quiet thought. I mostly had fun, but it felt like the game had lasted longer than it needed to, and track number 7 absolutely did it no favors. Even if it hadn't been for that level, though, there was no point during the game that I felt like I had experienced an early contender for Game of the Year. I experienced a fun game that I'm going to sit down and be unlikely to play for a very long time, and I suspect with the rest of the games coming out this year, it'll be a forgotten title in my library before I know it. What's sad is, I feel like a lot of people saying it's Game of the Year material now will be in the same boat here before too long. A common theme I've noticed is that people are using Hi-Fi Rush as a tool in a console war between Microsoft and Sony. A good game comes out that's exclusive to Xbox and PC, and they see that as the answer to Sony's exclusives on PlayStation and PC. And Microsoft hasn't exactly been filing out high-profile exclusives. Just a month ago, people were insisting Pentiment was Game of the Year material. And let's be honest, fucking how? On the bright side, Hi-Fi Rush is a more heartfelt and meaningful game than Microsoft fans have gotten in a long time. It's just not the Game of the Year contender they think it is. Thank you for tuning in to Jerwinko Gaming. I've been your host, Jonathan Irwin Jerwinko, and this has been my thoughts on Hi-Fi Rush from developer Tango Gameworks and publisher Bethesda Softworks. Hi-Fi Rush is available for $29.99 on Steam at this time, as well as other outlets including Epic Game Store. Thank you for watching this video. Please like or dislike as you see fit, comment down below, and consider subscribing to the channel. Along with views and viewer retention, activity from viewers in these small ways helps my channel and the algorithm, so keep that in mind whenever you're stopping by smaller content creators like myself in this hobby you know and love as video games. We really appreciate hearing from you and interacting with you all the time. If you really like my content, please consider checking out my Patreon in the links down below. We have several tiers available, ranging from run-of-the-mill to outstanding, but every tier is valued because your support means everything. One last time, this has been Jerwinko Gaming. I've been your host, Jonathan Irwin Jerwinko. And until next time, stay cool and stay gaming. I got people that don't like me in the industry. I can feel your energy. You were not a friend of me. Because I have been to places that you never wanted to.